The scope of this discussion has been unity feedback systems, right? So what do we do if it's a non-unity feedback system, right? So let's say you have this is slightly more than non-unity feedback system. I'll just give a simple example so that you. Okay, they have this system. If you have something like this, what is this E of S? You have to understand a little bit of block diagram reduction. E of S is what? You can say it is G 1 of S minus H 1 of S. Correct? Now if I have to change this to here, G of S is simply equal to G1 of S into G2 of S. Okay, and H of S is what? H1 of S divided by G1. So these two systems are equivalent or they are the same. Okay? So just think about again, this is slightly more than a non-unity feedback system. This would qualify for the simplest non-unity feedback system because there is an H of S. So let's see, let's understand what is C of S then for system 1. G 1 of G 2 of S times E of S, right? Which is G 2 of S multiplied by G 1 of S minus H 1 of S, right? For system 2.
So where did that R of S come into?
Oh, you're right. It is, there is R1 of S.
That means G of S.
It will just get multiplied. This whole thing.
The G1 of S.
So it is R of S multiplied by G1 of S minus H1 of S. Right. So here, this will simply change to C of S is G2. This will change to R of S. G 1 of S minus H 1 of S. Okay. If you look at the same thing for C2, for system 2, what is C of S? It is. So let's say here we say this is E of S. Okay? It is E of S multiplied by G of S. Correct? What did we say G of S was? This is E of S into G1 of S into G2 of S. And what is E of S? E of S itself. E of S is R of S minus H of S. Right? Which is R of S minus H1 of S. Divided by G1 of S. And if I substitute this here, now C of S is equal to R of S minus H1 of S, G1 of S. This whole thing multiplied by G1 of S. Okay. So do you see? Do you see now it is exactly equal to, this can be written as G2 of S.
This, that C almost looks like a little E.
So this is G1 of S, G2 of S, R of S, minus G2 of S into H1 of S. And similarly, this is also equal to, so you can say G2 of S compare these. Are they the same?
Oh, is the equation for one and system 1 and 2 the same? Mm-hmm.
The same, right?
Yes, they are.
So what happens here is when you shift this here. See, this signal gets multiplied by g1 of s, right? Or it gets multiplied by, so when you shift it here, it gets added, but when you shift it here, what you want to do is, now this signal gets multiplied by g1 of s. So if you want to shift it here, what you have to do is, you have to divide it by g1 of s, so that that cancels, and what you get here is simply h1 of s. Make sense?
So that, can you repeat that one more time?
See, when you shift signal like this, you have to keep the system the same. So what I've done here is, I've shifted this to here. You see, did you see that? And I've taken all these two inside. So the intermediate step would have been like this. You have g1, g2, and this is that h1 divided by g1.
Yeah.
When I shifted this signal, I divided this thing by g1 of s, because it gets multiplied. Again, when I do go here, whatever this signal is coming, it gets multiplied by g1 of s. Right? So to take care of that, you divide this by g1 of s. Okay? So let's just focus on this system.
Which one? What you said?
So this one you can expect, if you get something like this on exam, don't panic too much, just know how to do it, okay?
I'm sorry, can you repeat what you said?
Focus. If you get something like this on exam, don't panic. Just solve for it. Because you have to know some form of block diagram reduction. See, when you design your system, when you design your actual system, these blocks will be like, you know, small components. What are these blocks? These blocks are small subsystems. So this whole thing forms the system. You will not get a system like this directly. So you'll put blocks everywhere, and then ultimately what you'll try to do is you'll try to reduce that to a simple block.
So there are like problem-related diseases on the home.
I'll give you one problem related to this.
This one?
Yeah.
Yes,
sir. Do you like our homework should have a long case with a little bit more
than that? Sure. You can just look at textbook and then practice that. That is also fun.
Can you give us problems and we can check in the back of
the book? Yeah, there are a bunch of problems in the book which you can check. Alright, let's look at an example for. Now, how do you convert? Let's focus on this, okay? This is not an example. Converting non-unity feedback system to unity feedback. So you have this, G of S, you have H of S. So now what I'm going to do is, G of S minus plus minus plus.
So I have one question.
Hmm.
So no matter what the system, you are going to get that last equation because you have the potential. So any kind of system will have those equations last.
This is a general representation. See, this system, what it means is, this is a sensor. See, when you're designing your control system, you want to design closed loop control. And you have to understand what these how these sensors contribute to control. How do sensors contribute to control? Why are sensors so important to control?
They tell the system when and when not to do.
Sensors won't tell that system.
They can detect when the system.
Sensors will only give you the actual state of the system. What are sensors? What are your eyes? Will your eyes tell you what to do?
No.
What are your sensors? How do you, we have to compare, you have to drive an analogy to your sensors and senses. So if it's hot, will your will your sense of touch, will it tell you what to do or not to do?
Yeah.
What will tell you not what to do and not to do?
The brain
will tell you what to do or not to do. Okay? So your sensors, your ears, unless your brain tells your ears not to hear, the ear will not, you will not react. Right? So sensors are like what they see. They will just indicate what the state of the system. So this tells you, this sensor tells you what is the state of the system. So there is a control here, there is a smarts in the system which will tell you. So depending on how it senses, what it sees, that smarts will tell you, okay, go this direction, go that direction. So if you have been following, these automatic braking systems are going to be standard in all automobiles.
Now,
okay. So how will you do that if you were required to do that? Automatic braking work. If you
have a sensor that can know when something's in front of you.
Right, you have a proximity sensor which will tell you something is in front of you.
And
that has to be fed back to an intelligent controller inside the vehicle. And then the vehicle will automatically press on the brakes. Okay, so this is that sensor. Sensors don't have any intelligence in them. Sensors only sense. Okay. So this, does that answer your question, Raju? Why this? So this could be, there could be, you know, systems like this. Sensor may be feeding back only to a particular system. But if you want to solve it as an equivalent, you have to get it in this form. This is a very accepted closed loop feedback system. Okay? So here I have not changed anything. Okay? What I've done is I've just added a plus and a negative. Plus one, minus one. Okay? So here what happens is you have R of S. So this I can write as G of S. So G of S. C of S. Okay. And here I have H of S. -1. Minus, and then I'll keep this minus here. This is the R of S. So I've added these two signals. this signal and this signal.
That's why it's minus 1.
Minus of minus 1 would be plus 1, right? Minus of minus 1 would be plus 1. So that plus 1. Okay? So that signal, that is what you get. Now, how do you solve this signal? How do you combine this?
G of S multiplied by H of S minus 1.
It is G of S over 1 plus. This is a con, this is. You have to simply apply this feedback. You have learned this, right? G of S. How do you solve this? How do you solve for this equivalent system? GS over 1 plus GS HS. Okay? So you're just doing the same thing. Instead of HS, you have HS minus 1. Now what you have is, this one is GS over 1 plus GS into H of S minus 1. Have C of L. This goes back. Minus 1. So you have now converted it to a unity feedback system. Where G equivalent is what? So G equivalent of L is simply G of S divided by 1 plus G S multiplied by G S minus 1. So once you have converted this, you can apply your definition of unity feedback system. Let's take an example and look at it.
Isn't that a negative sign in the third one on the right side of the line?
Huh?
Isn't that a negative sign in the third one?
This one?
Yes, on the other side of that line.
What do you mean?
Is that a negative right there?
Yeah, that's a negative sign.
And then, right, you see on the other side of the line, is that a negative?
This one?
Yeah.
Yeah, that negative sign stays, right?
Okay.
Everything, all signals have to be, you have to mention what sign they.
What's the difference between these two systems?
Which systems?
Non-unity.
Unity. It's not multiplied by anything.
Okay.
So this is the output, the response is multiplied by H of S. Feedback. What is a feedback? Which is a feedback part? You understand feedback? What is being fed back? The output is being fed back. Okay, when it is fed back, if it is not multiplied by anything, it's a unity feedback. You see, unity is this output response is being fed back, right? The feedback response. So error here is what? This is error signal. Error is what? R of S minus H of S, C of S. Here, what is the error? Error here is R of S minus C of S. So the coefficient of this is 1. The coefficient of this is H of S. If the coefficient is anything other than 1, it's a non-unity feedback system. Try to get a sense of what control is. A Okay, and unless you get a sense of what control is, you will not close loop control, open loop control. So this is why is this closed loop control? Do you understand that, Micah?
No.
What are you trying to control here? What do you want to control? Okay. So do you see the output being controlled here?
Yes.
Huh?
You're choosing the standard.
See, the error is to, the design is to reduce this error. Okay. So what is the error? How is this error defined? Error is difference between input and output. You see that? You're always trying to control the error. In your whatever control system you're looking at, you're trying to control the error. There's a desired and there's a actual. So here it is. This is the desired. This is the actual. If the actual is transduced and put back, you know what transduced is? Converted into some other form. So we'll take a look at an example. So this is a non-unity feedback system. R of S is positive, this is negative, and this is 0. Okay. How do you convert this to unity feedback system? What is here? This is G of S. Okay. This block is G of S, this block is H of S. So what is G E of S? Equivalent is G of S divided by 1 plus G of S H of S minus 1. Okay. If you multiply that, that's what you want to get is 100 divided by S into S plus N 1 plus 100. Solve for this, what are you going to get is so I can write this system as equivalent unity feedback system. Yes. Just write this as G E of S. You may want to remember this formula, or if you don't want to remember this, you can actually just convert it yourself. Okay. So now, if I ask you what is the steady state error, find the system type, the appropriate error. So if I ask what is the steady state error, first step input, find steady state error for step input. What is the definition of steady state error for step input? You have, or just let's just remember this. E infinity is limit as s tends to 0, s r of s over 1 plus g of s. Right? So here what will happen is this g of s will change to one plus g e of s. That's it. And since you're looking at the steady state error for a step input, r of s will be what? R of s will be 1 over s. Now if you substitute this, it will be simply limit as s tends to 0, s 1 over s over 1 plus, you just have to copy this here, 100 divided by s into s plus m. 1 plus 100, 1 minus 5. Okay. If you, what do you do with this? You just have to substitute s equal to 0 to figure out the steady state. Do you guys get a sense of what is happening, or you don't get the sense of what is happening? Yes. Okay. Do you understand steady state error, first of all?
I understand with steady state error, the way I can like verbalize it is essentially...
Conceptually, what do you understand by steady state error?
Conceptually, there's an input going in, and based on the output, there might be some errors inside the in the function.
Error between what?
Error between the transfer function and the input. Like the number.
This is a problem. You cannot just put words. What do you understand? Conceptually, it is a very simple. I've explained it to you. Mathematically, I told you. I explained it with a response plot. What is steady state error?